I recently found this old microwave which contains a high voltage transformer, which can be easily rewinded to function as a high current transformer, which is widely used in welding. So in this video tutorial, I will show you how I failed building an arc welder or why you should not definitely try this at home. So let's get started. This video is sponsored by JLC PCB. They are known for high quality PCB prototype manufacturing. You can order 2 to 6 layer PCB from their website. To see production in progress, you just have to click one button. And build time is only 24 hours for 2 layer PCB. Check them out, link is in the video description. I started by removing a couple of screws which holds the top cover. But before that, don't forget to unplug the microwave. Once I was inside, first thing I needed to do was discharge the high voltage capacitor. For that, you can simply use two long screwdrivers and try to short the capacitor. Once capacitor is discharged, it's safe to touch inside. So I moved on and started removing all the components like relay board, capacitor and dozens of limit switches and a lot more. But I was more interested in transformer. Also, don't even dare to touch the magnetron, as it contains some beryllium oxide, so better stay away from that. Taking a look at transformer clearly reveals that top coil was secondary high voltage coil and the lower one was primary. So I used some hacksaw to slowly and carefully chop off the both ends of the secondary and later used a drill to remove the entire thing. In the end, I used some pliers to remove the remaining parts of the coil and used a screwdriver to knock off the shunts. Once this madness was over, I measured the dimension of the transformer and bought 16 square millimeter wire about 3 meter long and started rewinding the transformer. I was able to get about 8 turns in total. By doing so, we have successfully created a high current transformer. When I applied 230 volts AC on the input, I measured about 7.4 volts on the output. So I stripped down about 1 inch of the insulation on both ends and used the pliers to hold a welding stick. Then I went outside and tried to weld on this piece of metal that I had lying around. It was a bit rusty, so I tried to use some sanding paper on it and tried to weld, but due to low voltage, I was not able to successfully create any arc and I was getting only few sparks. After looking through internet, I realized that I need a bit more voltage to create some arcs. At this moment, I was pretty much done with this project because I need more voltage. For that, I need to rewind the transformer. But luckily, I found another microwave in a scrapyard which had similar transformer but with more power. So I repeated the same process of rewinding it with a plan to use both the transformer in series to create more or double the voltage. So after rewinding the transformer, I connected both the transformers in series and measured the output voltage. And I measured about 8.2 volts at the output, which was a bit strange for me at first because individually both the transformers were capable of producing about 7 to 8 volts. After looking around for a bit, I realized that both of my transformers were rated for 240 volts at the input. By connecting them in series, I am basically center tapping them, which means I am only giving 120 volts at the input, which is half the voltage they require. So all I needed to do was apply 240 volts AC to those transformer, which I am no way going to attempt because it involves messing around with two different phases of my house. A small mistake and I could possibly get myself in trouble. In the end, I took those two transformer and connected them in series, applied 240 volts AC at the input and tried to weld, which definitely failed. All I would like to say now is just go and buy one of those welding machines available on the Amazon. and don't cheap out on building one. So that's it for this video guys. If you enjoyed, don't forget to hit that like button, share this video with your friends and subscribe for more awesome content like this, and I will see you guys in the next one.